everybody.
Good morning.
And a warm welcome to our service. It is the 19th Sunday after Trinity, but of course far more important, it is our Harvest Thanksgiving. And I know there are some baskets to come up, and if they can come up during the first hymn, that would be absolutely lovely. The screen is up, but not because we're going back to having the words on the service on the screen, and you will see a little more about that later on anyway. Can I say thank you in advance to everybody that's brought gifts for the food bank? Steph and I took the gift from St Michael's down last week, and they really were very gratefully received. It is a great work, and thank you all in anticipation for everything that you are giving to keep the hungriest people in Stone from not having anything to eat today. Thank you very much indeed. Two notices though, just for your prayers. One is that St Michael's is beginning its Sunday school for the first time for a couple of years today. And also next Saturday is our first messy church again for a couple of years. So do pray for all of those. I think our benefice work with young people really is very, very important. So thank you all very much for that one, and do remember them. But one final notice is Operation Christmas Child. And yes, I know it's a C word already and it's only October, but never mind. These are the shoebox appeals, of course, again for the people of the world who have so very, very little. If you would like to take a shoebox with its instruction leaflet, Mary has them at the back and would be delighted to give you one, or two, or three, or however generous you are feeling on all of that. But seriously, if you could, that would be a great work as well. Thank you very much indeed.
Yeah.
Lynn has only just told me this just before the service, and I've still managed to forget it. Beautiful corn dollars, which I've already managed to knock off, but there we are. Thank you, Lynn, thank you. I think it's back on now. Lynn was saying, if you would like to buy a corn dolly and the proceeds go to church, then do please take one afterwards and give a donation. And whatever you feel is appropriate. I can't imagine how many hours of labour goes into the men. But nonetheless, thank you again in anticipation. So it really is, Ellie.
So our first hymn is hymn number 101, Come Ye Thankful People Come.
Oh,
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. And we say together, Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are given, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment. And the second is like, namely this, Thou shalt love thy neighbour as thyself. There is none other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Lord, have mercy upon us, and write all these thy laws in our hearts with these teachings.
The Lord be with you,
and with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Eternal Lord, you crown the year with your goodness, and you give us the fruits of the earth in their season. Grant that we may use them to your glory, for the relief of those in need, and for our own well-being. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Today's Old Testament reading is taken from Joel 2:21-27. Do not fear, O sorrow, be glad and rejoice, for the Lord has done great things. Do not fear, you animals of the field, for the pastures of the wilderness are green. The trees bear its fruit, the fig tree and vine give their full yield. O children of Zion, be glad and rejoice in the Lord your God. For he has given the early rain for your vindication. He has poured down for you abundant rain, the early and the later rain as before. The threshing floor shall be full of grain, the vat shall overflow with wine and oil. I will pay you for the years that the swarming locust has eaten, the hopper, the destroyer, and the cutter, my great army which I sent against you. You shall eat in plenty and be satisfied, and praise the name of the Lord your God, who has dealt wondrously with you, and my people shall never again be put to shame. You shall know that I am in the midst of Israel, and that I, the Lord, am your God, and there is no other, and my people shall never again be put to shame. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The epistle is taken from 1 Timothy 2:1-7. My dearly beloved, I urge that supplications, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgivings be made for everyone, for kings and all who are in high positions, so we may lead a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and dignity. This is right and this is acceptable in the sight of God our Saviour, who desires everyone to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. For there is one God, there is also one mediator between God and humankind, Christ Jesus, himself human, who gave himself a ransom for all that was attested at the right time. For this I was appointed a herald and an apostle. I am telling the truth, I am not lying, a teacher of the Gentiles in faith and in truth. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
Stand to sing hymn number 186, Great is Thy Faith.
Matthew, the 6th chapter, beginning to read at the 25th verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into the barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? And can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your span of life? Why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin, yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today and tomorrow thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, you of little faith? Therefore, do not worry, saying, 'What will we eat, or what will we drink, or what will we wear?' For it is the Gentiles who strive for all these things. And indeed, your heavenly Father knows you need all these things. But strive first for the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
Harvest, harvest. So many different things you can say about harvest. I love the bit about do not worry. I'm the world's worst worrier about things at times, sometimes. But nevertheless, the point about harvest mostly, of course, is to give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Nice quotation from the Old Testament for you there, of course. So many different things you can say. The God who gives us these things, the God who demonstrates his love for us, and the God who renews the face of the earth in every way as we go through the harvest season. But I've chosen to do something a little bit different this morning. So I will ask you, has anyone here heard of the Garden Gang? Our children loved it when they were little. The Garden Gang, different stories there. You've got about Oliver Onion and Tin Tomato and all the rest of it. Best thing about the Garden Gang is all those stories were written by a child still at primary school. And I do hope she got her due reward for all of that, because you never know, do you, with all these things. So the Garden Gang, of course, about fruit and vegetables, always who had all their own personalities and each had their own little story about them. I'm glad some of us knew them anyway. Right, but I'm not going to tell you about the Garden Gang today. I'm going to tell you about the Fruit and Veg Gang instead. Fruit and Veg Gang all live together in the harvest basket, and again, all the fruit and veg had their own personalities. Well, amongst them we had Alfie Apple. Nice red apple there, you see, and all the rest of it looking for you. And Oliver Orange. And didn't stop there, there were a lot more of them too. There was Lucy Lemon, and Gertie Grapefruit, and Priscilla Peach. I had an Auntie Gertie, by the way, it's a long time ago. She was a great aunt, really, of course. But there we go. Who else was there? Let's have a look. Oh, yes, of course, it was Fruit and Veg Gang, of course. We also had Percy Pepper. And they all lived together very happily together as the Fruit and Veg Gang in the harvest basket. Very nice too. But there was a snag. They all thought they were better than anybody else. Do we like people who think they're better than anybody else? No, absolutely not. There you go, you see, I thought you'd like that one there. Little dancing dog, I'm better than you and all the rest of it. We all know people who are like that as well. People who constantly look down their noses at you, don't we? But nonetheless, it's usually never true when it's their problem, not ours. Okay. Right. One day, of course, to the Fruit and Veg Gang came somebody else. Peter Potato. Now, I'm very much afraid they were completely horrible to him.
"Ugh, I bet not you. Oh, you all got a messy, dirty skin, and you've come out of the garden and they haven't even bothered washing, and we don't like you.
We all think we're better than you."
just want to make sure you're still awake.
And so they were particularly horrible to him, amazing by his life and misery is part of the fruit and veg gang in the harvest basket. But the day came, of course, as it must do for all fruit and vegetables, when it came time for them to be used. And then we found out the truth of whether or not they were really better than anybody else. Alfie Apple looked wonderful on the outside, red and shiny and all the rest of it. But when they sliced him open, right in the middle, they found a pip. We all know people who give us the pip, don't we? My word, yes, you know, those sort of people who are always going on about themselves and how good they are and how they've done this and that and the other and all the rest of it. Alfie Apple wasn't better than anybody else. He was somebody who gave you the pip. And then you see, it went on. When you got to Lucy Lemon, anyone tried biting into a lemon recently? Yeah. Well done, Eleanor, you're braver than I am, I have to say. It can give you a very sour face indeed, of course. Because, of course, Lucy Lemon has an awful lot of acid to her. She wasn't really a nice person at all. Same could be said even of Gertie Grapefruit. If you eat grapefruit, lots of people prefer to eat them with lots and lots of sugar. Absolutely. Not very good if you're a diabetic, is it, Berlin, but not that. Right, okay, so those were those two. Well, those three, I should say. But it didn't stop there either. When you got to Priscilla Peach and cut her open, she found she had a heart of stone. Right, yeah, she didn't care about anybody other than herself. She was really not a nice person at all. She didn't even care about the other people who were part of the fruit and veg gang. And when they got to Percy Pepper, cut him open, there was nothing to him at all. Completely personality missing. So, were they better than anybody else? No, of course they weren't. But when we got to Peter Potato, and they cut him open, they found he had a heart of gold. So does it really matter what we look like on the outside, rather than on the inside? No, of course it doesn't. In the end of the day, our God is somebody who judges not on appearances, but what we're like in our hearts. So the question really for harvest for us is, what's your heart really like? And I want to suggest to you this morning that over the last few weeks, perhaps we've found out what some people's hearts are like. Yeah, petrol pumps, sorry, out of use. Sorry, don't you sit in the wrong place? Me first. I must have petrol before anybody else because I'm the most important. True? No, not at all of it. But the good news really about harvest, more than anything else, is another quotation from the Old Testament, from the prophet Ezekiel. When God promises, I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit within you, and I will remove from you your heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. The nastiest person of all can be made into a better person when they turn to Jesus. And perhaps that's the most important lesson of harvest of all. Let's say a prayer. Father, we thank you for the harvest and for the wonderful provision you give us. Enough for ourselves, but more than that, enough for the whole world, if only we aren't mean and selfish about it. Help us as we turn to you to be reminded of the harvest promise, that you will give us that heart of flesh to turn to worship you, the one true God, through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please stand as we share our faith in the words of the Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate of the Holy Ghost, the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried. The third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins. And I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
And your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. Our offertory hymn 524, To Thee, O Lord, Our Hearts We Raise.
Swallows flight and moonlight rays. God of the harvest.
We see the Creator's hand.
In the brown of leaves once green, morning mists, autumn chill, fruit that falls, and frost's first kiss. God of the harvest.
We see the Creator's hand.
By the word of our Lord, the heavens were made, and by the Spirit of our Lord was life begun. By the wisdom of our Lord, his laws were laid, and by the love of our Lord was born his Son. By the grace of our Lord, mankind was saved, and by the power of our Lord, the victory was won. God of the harvest.
We see the Creator's hand.
Creator God, Gardener Supreme, you place us at the centre, feed us, equip us, and having provided for us, look to a different harvest. A fruitfulness of lives in service to you and to others. Lord, feed us and prune us and harvest us, that our lives might bring glory to you. God of the harvest.
We see the Creator's hand.
Creator God, forgive our moments of ingratitude, the spiritual blindness that prevents us from appreciating the wonder that is this world, the endless cycle of nature, of life, death, and rebirth. Forgive us for taking without giving, reaping without sowing. Open our eyes to see, our lips to praise, our hands to share. May our feet tread lightly on the path we tread, and our footsteps be worthy of following, for they lead to you. God of the harvest.
We see the Creator's hand.
Great physician, stretch out your hand to bring comfort, wholeness and peace to all who suffer in body, mind or spirit. Fill us with compassion that we may be channels of your healing love. And this morning we lift before you Elsie Richardson, Vera Tompkinson, Pat Wynne, Gary Kelsall, John Richardson, Peter Bowler, Catherine Ritchie, Miles Brain, John and Anne Shuckleworth, Margaret Wright, Molly Wright, Norman Latham, Gillian Wright, John Hargreaves, Val Morris, June Stringer, Jim Hammersley, Alison Holmes, Pam Miles, Lewis Hubbard, Jean Gulliver, Margaret Tomlinson, Dave McGlynn, Sue Kensington, Elsie Woodcock, Lindsay Knowles, Carl Hartley, and Mike Thompson. Conqueror of death, remember for good those whom we love but no longer see. Help us to live this day in the sure and certain hope of your eternal victory. And we pray this morning for those recently departed, Catherine Cool, Faye Maskery, and John Sanders. And we remember their families and friends at this time. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Ye that do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbours and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession to Almighty God, meekly kneeling upon your knees.
Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honour and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all them that with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Saviour Christ saith unto all that truly turn to him. Come unto me, all that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith, this is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith, if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there by his one oblation of himself once offered a full, perfect and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that, his precious death, until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech thee. Grant that we, receiving these, thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. Who, in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he brake it, and gave it unto his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me. Amen.
live on the Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Lord himself has taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. O Lord and Heavenly Father, we thy humble servants entirely desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son Jesus Christ and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that all we who are partakers of this heavenly holy communion may be fulfilled with thy grace and heavenly benediction. And although we be unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offences. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honour and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen. And if you are able, would you please stand? Glory be to God on high, and in earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee. We give thanks to thee for thy great glory, O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty. O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art most high in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Christ, who has nourished us with himself, the living bread, make you one in praise and love, and raise you up at the last day. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen. Our final hymn, of course, We Plough the Fields and Scatter, 5, 3, 4.